In this video, we're looking at a projectile motion problem where we have a person throwing a baseball. They release the baseball from 2 meters above the ground at an angle of 40 degrees with respect to the horizontal, and the initial speed is 30 meters per second. And what we're trying to find in the problem is the range, in other words, the total horizontal distance traveled by the ball during the flight, and then we're going to find the maximum height of the ball. So the first priority here is to break the initial velocity into its components. So there's the initial x velocity pointing to the right, and we call that v0x. And we can pick out v0x as a component here by taking the hypotenuse, that's 30 meters per second, and multiplying by the cosine of 40 degrees. And this gives us about 22.98 meters per second. We do a similar thing for v0y. Except we pick out that component using the sine function, so 30 sine 40 degrees, and that gives us about 19.28 meters per second. So next we need to start analyzing the kinematics, and one of the big clues on how to start is to look at the landing of this thing, the end of the flight, and we have a little extra information there about the y direction, so we're going to do a y analysis of the problem. So that little bit of extra information is that the final y value is equal to zero. So if we look at our kinematic equation for the y position as a function of time, we have y equals y naught plus v naught yt. Just being very careful here to talk about the y component of velocity, not the total speed, and then plus 1/2 at squared. So it's our basic constant acceleration equation for the y position. And now we can plug in the things we know. We know the final position in the y direction is zero. The initial, well, we're going to say the origin is at the ground level, which means our initial y value is 2 meters. And we can plug in our initial y velocity, 19.28 times t. And then we plug in our y acceleration, which is negative g. It's negative 9.8 meters per second squared. If I take half that, I get negative 4.9 for this coefficient. So negative 4.9 t squared. Now this gives us a quadratic equation. And you can plug in all the coefficients to the quadratic formula or plug into a quadratic solver in your calculator or even just type it into a Google search window to get the results here. One of the times you get out of this is negative, and we're going to ignore that one. The positive time we get, that's a flight time of 4.04 seconds. All right, so now we know how long the ball stays in the air, and we know from the beginning how fast it's moving to the right. It's going to keep moving at that same speed of 22.98 meters per second to the right the entire time because there's no x acceleration in a projectile motion problem. So now we're thinking about our horizontal analysis, x equals x naught plus v naught xt. We're going to call our initial x position zero. And our final x position, that's what we call the range. So we have the range is equal to the x velocity, that's 22.98. That never changes. So this is really just a distance equals rate times time kind of problem. And we know how long it's doing this, 4.04 seconds. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 92.8 meters for the range. Finally, we're going to get the maximum height for the ball. And the key physical piece that we know about the maximum height is that's the moment where the ball is transitioning between moving up and moving down. And at the transition between positive and negative y velocity, the y velocity must be zero for that instant in time. So there's more than one way to find the maximum height. We could find the time it takes to get to the maximum height and then plug that into the y position equation. But one of our kinematics equations gets everything done in one step. That's the time independent kinematics equation. Vy squared is v naught y squared plus 2 times ay times final y position minus initial y position. So our final y velocity at the location of the maximum height is zero. We can plug in our initial y velocity, which was 19.28, and we're going to square that. And then we plug in ay, which again is negative 9.8. So I'm just going to write the minus sign out front. So minus 2 times 9.8. And then we have our final y value. That's what we're looking for. That's the maximum height minus the initial y value, which was 2 meters above the ground where we implicitly put our origin. So you can subtract the 19.28 squared from both sides, divide by negative 2 times 9.8, and then add 2 to the result to solve for y all at once in your calculator. And that's what we call h max. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, I get 21.0 meters for the maximum height. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.